In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May the grace and peace of God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, welcome to St. Charles Borromeo. It is good to see you all, to be here to celebrate the Mass at 5 p.m., this evening Mass, the Vigil Mass, that is celebrated on Saturday, but is the Mass for tomorrow, for Sunday. And we are celebrating the 18th Sunday in ordinary time. The Mass intention, we offer it for Howard and Marcel Story. I remember Marcel Story. She was a parishioner, member of the Altar Society, and her brother was a priest, so we pray for them, for Marcel Story and Howard. And we also pray today for all of your intentions as we gather this evening. Today we have a new piano lady, we have a new organist, and you know Their parents have been parishioners for many, many years. Juan and Griselda Ramirez, so they're here today. She's a high school teacher, and she's a student, already graduated. Just graduated. Let us give them a hand of applause. Thank you for being here today. And you know me, Father Miguel Solorzano, and we have Mr. Cantu, Clemente Cantu, who has been also in the neighborhood for many years, but for about 18 years, he helped all the way to Mount Carmel Church, and now he's back with us. And I'm glad that he's here today to help. He's an acolyte, and he's helping today at this Mass. Today's message is centered on feeding, how Jesus feeds us, not only physically, but spiritually. After preaching, then he fed 5,000 people, the multiplication of the fish and the bread. And the second reading today talks about the love of Christ. What can separate us from the love of Christ? Nothing should separate us from the love of Christ. So my dear brothers and sisters in Christ, as we gather this evening around the table of the Lord to celebrate this Holy Eucharist, let us pause for a moment, acknowledge our sins, and pray for God's mercy and forgiveness. In silence, let us do an examination of our conscience. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you. Glory, Lord God, heavenly King.
Let us pray. Draw near to your servants, O Lord, and answer their prayers with unceasing kindness, that for those who glory in you as their creator and guide, you may restore what you have created and keep safe what you have restored, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us now be seated to listen to the Word of God.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, all you who are thirsty, come to the water. You who have no money, come, receive grain and eat. Come without paying and without cost, drink wine and milk. Why spend your money for what is not bread, your wages for what it fails to satisfy? Heed me, and you shall eat well. You shall delight in rich fare. Come to me heedfully. Listen, that you might have life. I will renew with you the everlasting covenant, the benefits assured to David, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The hand of the Lord feeds us. He answers all our prayers and needs. The hand of the Lord feeds us. He answers all our needs. The Lord is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and of great kindness. The Lord is good to all and compassionate toward all his works. The hand of the Lord feeds us. He answers all our needs. The eyes of all look hopeful to you, and you give them their food in due season. You open your hand and satisfy the desire of every living thing.
her soul on ease. The Lord is just in all his ways, and holy in all his works. The Lord is near to all who call upon him, to all who call upon him in truth. The hand of the Lord feeds us, he answers all our needs.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, what will separate us from the love of Christ? Will anguish or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or the sword? No. In all these things we conquer overwhelmingly through him who love us. For I am convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor present things, nor future things, nor powers, nor height, nor deep, nor any other creature will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Bread alone, but on every word that comes forth from the mouth of God.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
May the Lord be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "The kingdom of heaven is like a treasure buried in a field, which a person finds and hides again." A proclamation from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. When Jesus heard of the death of John the Baptist, he withdrew in a boat to a deserted place by himself. The crowds heard of this and followed him on foot from their towns. When he disembarked and saw the vast crowds, his heart was moved with pity for them, and he cured their sick. When it was evening, the disciples approached him and said, "This is a deserted place, and it is already late. Dismiss the crowds so that they can go to the villages and buy food for themselves." Jesus said to them, "There is no need for them to go away. Give them some food yourselves." But they said to him, "Five loaves and two fish are all we have here." Then he said, "Bring them here to me." And he ordered the crowds to sit down on the grass. Taking the five loaves and the two fish, and looking up to heaven, He said the blessing, broke the loaves, and gave them to the disciples, who in turn gave them to the crowds. They all ate and were satisfied. And they picked up the fragments left over, 12 wicker baskets full. Those who ate were about 5,000 men, not counting women and children. The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ. Today we are celebrating the 18th Sunday in Ordinary Time. In the first reading today from the prophet Isaiah, we see how the prophet is exhorting the people of Israel to come, drink, and eat for free, talking about God's generosity. Come to the water and be renewed by the everlasting covenant. In the second reading today, from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans, Paul tells the Romans that nothing can separate them from the love of Christ, nor death, nor the sword, not anything. Anything can separate us from the love of Christ. In the Gospel, after hearing of the death of John the Baptist, Jesus heals the sick and feeds the 5,000 abundantly. At the end of the Sermon on the Mount, when the sermon was over, Jesus also multiplies the food for those who are hungry. Christ gives us all we need to feed those he calls us to serve. Today's readings calls us, like the disciples, to feed ourselves, but only after having been nourished ourselves. In order for us to feed others, we need to be fed ourselves. And we are invited to delight in rich fare, fasting on the love of God that is stronger than death. In responding to God's call, we can trust that Christ will give us all we need to carry out his commands. During these days of the coronavirus, many people have come for food. We appreciate the food bank that is giving us food for us to distribute. But today, the verse that we proclaim before the Gospel says, not on bread alone man is fed, but also man is fed on every word that is uttered out of the voice of the mouth of God. So we need not only physical nourishment, but we need the spiritual nourishment. And well, I imagine now that many people are not attending church, I mean, it's already so many months away from church, and maybe people are not even watching the readings online. I mean, being away from the Word of God, being away from the Eucharist, we are somehow not being nourished spiritually. So we need to return to the satisfaction of our spiritual needs, to receive the Word of God, especially now, especially during the coronavirus. It is more important to rely on God, to be fed spiritually by the Lord. So today, as we read, so this weekend, if you wonder what is this weekend's topic, the multiplication of the fish and the bread. Jesus multiplies our resources so that people may be nourished. So today, let us think about not only the physical needs but the spiritual needs, not to neglect the spiritual needs that we all have, and to remember not on bread alone people are fed, but on the Word of God itself. Let us now stand and proclaim our creed together. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and he is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us bring our prayers and petitions before the Lord, who answers all our needs. Please respond after each petition. Lord, hear our prayers.
Lord, hear our prayers. For the church, that we may continually dedicate ourselves to feeding the hungry, satisfying the thirsty, clothing the naked, and welcoming the stranger, caring for all the ill, and visiting the imprisoned, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That leaders across the country and around the world may work together to eradicate hunger, homelessness, and poverty in every city, town, and nation. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayers. For those who work on farms and ranches, on the sea, or in factories to provide food for the world, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayers. That we may be welcoming community, always inviting those with sincere hearts to join us at our feast, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayers. For the faithful who have gone before us in special way, for the people of St. Charles, may they receive the rewards of eternal life in heaven. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayers.
Bounteous God, generous God, may your generosity be a model and an inspiration for us as we strive to share with those in need. Listen to our needs and grace us with all good gifts through your Son, our Lord, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen. The second collection is for DSF, Diocesan Services Fund. Children, please come forward to put your offering in the children's collection basket.
Dreams, take my mind with all.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Graciously sanctify these gifts, O Lord, we pray, and accepting the oblation of this spiritual sacrifice, make of us an eternal offering to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift it up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you lay the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You form man in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made, and forever praise you in your mighty works, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Daniel, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Marcel's story, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Jesus taught us to call God our Father at the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. And now from a distance, let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy to be shown to you, but I will not be worthy to be shown to you. May the body and the blood of Christ bring us to life everlasting. Body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. 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 The body of Christ.
Taste and see.
Let us pray. Accompany with constant protection, O Lord, those you renew with these heavenly gifts, and in your never-failing care for them, may them worthy of eternal redemption through Christ our Lord. Please be seated for a moment. We don't have a date yet for the catechism because of the coronavirus. As you know, classes in some places have not resumed. They don't have classes for children yet, so we don't have a date yet when we're going to have catechism. So we are not enrolling in informal classes right now. But we do have two sisters in our community who are in charge of catechism, and they are Sister Conchita and Sister Vidalina. And now, for the next months, home catechism will be recommended, at least for August, September, as we renew our in-person classes. So right now we encourage parents to teach their children. And even before the coronavirus, parents were supposed to teach catechism to their children, and they could be supervised by Sister Conchita and Sister Vidalina. They can have a book, and they can review if the child is being prepared for confession or First Communion or confirmation. So for the next 2 months, they are not wasting their time. They could begin to be prepared to read. Also, we are postponing the catechumens who were supposed to be baptized during Easter. They are still on hold, waiting for a day. We are just waiting when people feel more confident to come back to have the ceremony. So also we have a texting service, very popular in many parishes. It is called flocknote.com, and we have the word gospel for the people who attend masses in English. So if you pull out your phone and you text the word gospel to a short number that you can save as a contact, it's a 5-digit number. If you have a cell phone, pull out your cell phone and let me give you the number. The number is 84576. Again, 84576. Save it as a contact, and then text the word gospel to that number, and that way you join our texting network. So the number again, 84576, and the word to text is gospel. And that way, when we have a particular event or an announcement, we can text you a message, and then you know what's going on. Also, regarding maintenance of our facilities, if you see that a kneeler is broken or loose, please tell Vladimir. I noticed when I was coming in that one of the kneelers is loose, so tell Vladimir so he informed the carpenter to fix it. So if you see a kneeler that is loose or broken or something is not in its place, please let Vladimir know so that he can fix it and repair it. And again, I want to thank the two ladies who sang today. So could you introduce yourself, your names? What are you?
I'm Karen Ramirez.
Karen Ramirez and?
Cecilia Ramirez.
Cecilia and Karen. Well, let us give them a hand of applause. Thank you for coming today. You may know their parents, Juan and Griselda Ramirez. They've been singing in before here for many years. Even before I came, they were already here. So we appreciate them coming today. Berta is still with us, but now she has a granddaughter or grandson. And in the evenings, she's taking care of the grandson or granddaughter. So that's the reason why She's not able to come in the evenings, but she comes on Sunday morning, Berta Salazar. And then John Torres, who sings sometimes with us, he is at St. Gregory, but I think currently, first he was sick, then he got cured, and then I think his wife got sick, and then she got cured. Now I think it's the mother who is sick, so he's taking care of some relatives. But we pray for John Torres that he may also return eventually to play with us. And I think those are the main announcements. Make sure you pick up a bulletin. Take a bulletin with you. Read your bulletin. We have good reflections. And also for those of you, if you know someone who needs groceries, every Wednesday we distribute lots of groceries at 3 p.m. Groceries are given for free at 3 p.m. on Wednesdays and on Fridays. So every Wednesday at 3 p.m. and Friday at 3 p.m. and the second and fourth Saturday of the month at 8 a.m. Please stand for the blessing. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Our Holy Eucharist has ended. Let us now go in peace to love and serve the Lord.